Church, I proudly and willingly stand here today because of no other than the man above who has been guiding and protecting me all the way. This entire day would not be possible without the help of the AYM staff and the different departments. I would like to acknowledge all the AY leaders and staff that are fellowshipping with us today. Please stand. Any AYM staff? Amen. Amen. I would like to also acknowledge the Adventist Youth Federation, as well as I want to thank the Youth Ministry for all their support. Special thank you to Pastor Rohan Spencer. He has supported all our ideas, and he has made this day also possible. We'd like to acknowledge all the visitors, and I hope that you have a spirit-filled and blessed day.
Amen. Amen. I woke up this morning thinking about a friend that Laos In Harmony had about maybe 7-8 years ago, probably 9. And the conversation I had with him was on a Friday night. young man, extremely talented, blessed with musical abilities, born in the church. But for some reason we live in the same building, and he started to go out a lot more, go to a lot more clubs. And I talked to him, I asked him, I said, you know, you're in church, man, you know, God gave you a gift. And he kept telling me, you know, I know that what I'm supposed to do, I know what's right, but I just want to live a little. He said, you know, once this summer is done, trust me, I'm coming to church. I'm getting my life back in order. What? Just give me this summer. And it's almost like he was asking me to give him the summer. I said, you got to talk to God. But I'm telling you, tomorrow's not. He said, I know, but I just want the summer. Just let me live. Well, I got a call. Laos was at a restaurant eating, and I got a call from my dad. He said, Joseph's been shot. And we all everything just shut down for a second. We said a prayer right there, and about 3 minutes later, I got a call. He said, Joseph died. So, Joseph went to the club Friday night. Young people, I need y'all to listen up, because this is for you. This is for everybody, as a matter of fact. Joseph went to that club Friday night. He drank a little and got into an altercation with a young lady that he didn't want to dance with. And she got so upset that he rejected her. She got her cousin that was in a gang. And as he was fresh coming out of church service, came out of church service on Sunday, playing the drums for his grandmother's church, in a white suit, as he came out from his door, they shot him dead. Right on the doorstep. And it's a constant reminder to me that tomorrow isn't promised. Don't bank on your youth. What God brought you through could have killed somebody else. So we're just here today to be a reminder that God is asking for your heart today, right now. You have no time. Amen?
Somebody else.
Come on, Leo, you were says this life.
This life is not a resting place.
But this life.
This life.
Is a what?
Is a testing place.
But you know that God is going to bring you out of it. You know He's all powerful, all knowing. And He will bring you out of it. Amen. We are Laos In Harmony. We're just excited to be here, especially for the young people. pastor said something that I had to put my own spin on it. I don't think that the young people should only have that type of excitement. I think it should be everybody. When God comes, I'm going to be jumping up for joy. Are you? Oh, some of us, I'm not sure. Probably. Are we going to be excited for the second coming of Christ?
Yes.
So here's what we got to do. Young people, this is what we got to do. Say this. As for me and my house.
As for me and my house.
We will. Finish it for me.
Serve.
Now come on, say it all loud. As for me and my house.
As for me and my house.
We will.
Serve the Lord.
Get ready. We just want to say that we're living in a time where so much chaos is going on. Can we agree? But it's time for us to get back to the Word. So if the Word says, for me and my house will serve the Lord, it doesn't matter who my president is.
Amen.
Come on, I should have got a bigger amen. Some of us, you know what's going on right now. It doesn't matter, young people, who my professor is. Sometimes it may not even matter who my friends who stabbed me in the back are. As for me and my house, we got one job. Serve the Lord.
Motivated, dedicated, to give my time, to give my.
sacrifice.
Above all powers, above all.
Is
for me.
I am a pair of these afflictions, eclipsed by
Anytime you start Jesus to come to mind,
It just happens steady, you never begin on the process. Is there a place that you want to go in because you cannot go?
Should you still go anywhere? Mm-hmm.
Now, we are from the American people. We might have been with you. We think that the fact that we came all the way since about morning, 8 a.m. we just have a school. We stay for afternoon program, but we study. Hey, why? You're the last one. You get Friday night, we are meeting Wednesday night. You think you can spend time with us? I know the Bible says that whether two or three gathered on his name is free, but maybe not for you. Maybe for my sister who come with true worship God. But for you, you are in church, but your mind is somewhere else. God is not with you. We make a one thing. That's the difference. There's a difference between being one so much or being with someone. Sometimes we say, okay, well, I'm going to spend time. Tonight is family night. I'm going to watch a movie at the movie theater with the family. You're not spending time with your family. You're spending time around you. Because at the movie theater, wherever you stay, and you keep your cooking, you cannot talk to anyone, interact or disturb anyone. But when you're at home, that's when you're able to interact with the kids, eating, go to the refrigerator. That's when you're spending time with them. You're not the one who's spending time.